You might not know the name McKissack and McKissack, but you know the firm's work. McKissack is the architect of record for the Martin Luther King Jr. Memorial in Washington, D.C. The firm designed the presidential viewing stands for inaugurations for President Obama and President Trump, and it played a big part in the Washington Nationals' new baseball stadium. McKissack and McKissack is now taking on a bigger project, helping manage the building of Barack Obama's presidential library in Chicago. In studio is Daryl McKissack, the president and chief executive of McKissack and McKissack. Good morning, it's good to see you.
Good to see you too, Jason.
You've had so many high profile projects, some on the Washington Mall as well. How does a presidential library rank?
Oh my gosh, very high. It's probably the top of my list right now because it's the current one that I'm working on.
You're an architect, but your firm is playing kind of an oversight role for the Obama Presidential Center in Chicago. What specifically will your team be doing?
So we, as the project managers, are responsible for taking the vision and making it a reality. So we're the glue that helps the design team, the construction team, and the owner work together to make sure that we have the building that they want.
Make sure it all works out. I visited six presidential libraries, each obviously unique in their own respects. How will the Obama Presidential Library be any different from the others?
Well, first of all, it's the presidential, it's the Barack Obama Presidential Center. It's not just the
museum, library grounds, and everything.
Yes, it's a museum. It's going to have a lot of community activities, or space for community activity. So it's much more than just a museum, and they also are online. So worldwide, they've already launched many programs virtually.
Construction starts later this year. It's complete hopefully in 3 years. What's the biggest challenge you expect?
There's always challenges. There's always the dealing with the stakeholders, which there are many when you're dealing with a project like this. And also, you know, making sure it's a very high design, very complex project. So making sure that the contractor is sensitive to all of that, which we have a great construction team, Presidential Partners, which is made up of local firms in Chicago, as well as Turner Construction, which is a national company.
What kind of satisfaction do you get out of your job?
Well, you know, I'm writing a speech for today for the Women's Leadership Summit.
Which you're in town speaking with.
Yes, and I was asked to talk about our projects, but really our projects are inspirational for people. And they're part of a purpose and a movement. And so for me, the satisfaction is each project I learn something new as to why I need to keep moving forward in life and keep building and engineering my life, as well as helping to build and engineer the lives of others.
Daryl, last question for you too. Your family has an incredible story. Share this briefly about your great-great-grandfather back in 1790.
Yes, my great-great-grandfather was a slave, and he came here in 1790. He was a builder as a slave and passed the trade of building down to my great-grandfather, who passed it to my grandfather. And my grandfather and his brother went to corresponding school to become architects and started our family business in Tennessee in 1905, making us the oldest African-American architectural firm in the country. They were the first licensed black architects in Tennessee and in many neighboring states around Tennessee. They designed and built the Tuskegee Air Force Base, which was, you know, built during World War II.
1942.
Yeah.
Wow. You have an incredible family story, and you know, you and your sister both have your own individual firms and very successful. So thanks for coming in. Good luck to you on this latest project as well.
All right. Thank you, Jason. Thank